Hello viewers, welcome to Scientific Biology. Myself Satyendra, and today we will see the complete structure and function of a human heart. So keep watching and let's see this video.
The human heart is hollow, cone-shaped muscular organ that lies in the thoracic cavity in between the two lungs and remains slightly inclined towards the left side of the body. The upper broad end is called base and the lower tip is called apex. Human heart is 12 cm long and 8 cm broad. A human heart consists of 4 chambers and these are left atrium, left ventricle, the right atrium and the right ventricles. The two upper chamber called atria receive blood and the two lower chamber called ventricles pump out the blood. Each chamber of heart is separated by the cardiac muscles and the valves. The valves effectively moves blood throughout the heart in one direction. The atrioventricular or AV valve are between the atria and ventricle on each side of the heart. They are tricuspid and bicuspid or mitral valve. The tricuspid is on the right side and the bicuspid is on the left side. There are also two semilunar or SL valve, the pulmonary and the aortic valve. The pulmonary valve is between the right ventricle and the pulmonary trunk, and the aortic valve is between the left ventricle and the aorta. The tricuspid has three flexible cusps or the leaflets, and the bicuspid valve has two. The deoxygenated blood first enters to the right atrium by superior or inferior vena cava. Now the blood passes to right ventricle through the tricuspid valve. By the contraction of ventricles, the blood is then enters to the lungs through pulmonary semilunar valve. The oxygenated blood then returns to the left side of the heart. The oxygen-rich blood first enters to left atrium by pulmonary vein. The blood then passes to the left ventricle through the bicuspid valve. By the contraction of ventricle, the oxygen-rich blood enters to the aorta through aortic semilunar valve. Watch how blood flows through the heart. This diagram shows the blood entering the heart from the body. This blood is deoxygenated. After traveling to the lungs, it returns to the heart in the form of oxygenated blood. This process repeated itself over and over again to effectively deliver oxygen and nutrient to your body.